going to be doing a comprehensive oil change on the Z125 Pro by Kawasaki. I'm gonna try to make this as simple as possible because I saw some other videos and it was kind of complicated. First thing you're gonna need is the oil. 10W40 oil, that's what it takes. You could do other oil if you want, but I'm just gonna go by the manual that I have. Socket set, obviously, and I am using the K&N 112 filter. I read on their website that this is the filter that works for the 125. I hope that it is. If it isn't, I'm gonna be fucking pissed. The other thing that you're gonna need is a pan. Now, as you could probably tell, this is not an oil pan. I'm using this because my oil pan won't fit under this little ass tiny fucking bike. As you could probably tell, I have the bike running, right? And the reason for that is that you warm the oil up and it comes out faster. I'm not gonna get technical and all that kind of bullshit. It's just, it goes faster that way. So you let the bike warm up and the oil gets warmer and then you can change the oil faster. The first thing that you're gonna need to do, thanks to Kawasaki, they try to make their bike a little bit, I guess, more complicated and cool looking. They have this little fairing piece body thing that you has to come off in order to get to the filter and the oil to the oil filter and the oil drain bolt. In order to take this off, you're gonna need an Allen head key or wrench, whatever. Every one of the bolts is exactly the same except for the top right bolt. It's much longer and it has this plastic piece on it. Don't lose it. And let's get this shit started. The size socket you're gonna need is a 17 for the actual oil drain bolt, which is located near the exhaust pipe, so don't burn yourself, all right? And this thing right here is where the oil filter is, per another video that I saw that was very confusing and dragged on forever. There's two bolts, right? And they're both 8mm. According to the other video, I will find out if that's right or if it isn't right. The next thing I'm gonna do is put some oil on this drain plug and I'm going to put it back into the bike and then I'm gonna take the filter out. It has stopped dripping, took a little bit, but we're all good. I would leave it out, but I don't want it to drip all into the grass, and I have my dog here and I don't want him licking it up. You wanna hand tighten that bolt first, and then you wanna tighten this down. Not too tight, you don't wanna break the goddamn thing off the bike. The oil filter cover came off the bike. I'll show you exactly where it came off of. Came off of right here, see where the filter is? And a good amount of oil actually did come out of here even after I drained all the oil on the bike. So just have your pan prepared. As you could tell, I kind of dicked it up a little bit. There's the O-ring. See if I get some light on it. It looks really good. I'm just going to clean up some of this shit around there and I'm going to reuse it. As the other guy in his other video said, there is a spring on the inside of here and it does come loose, so just, you know, prepare Uranus. I'm going to take this filter off. Yeah, I might as well do it here on camera. Oh yeah, sexy ass filter. Pour it out. It's gonna have some shit in there. I'm just gonna clean off the surface, wipe some oil on the new one, and hope to God that it's the same son of a bitch filter. That's the old filter. This is the new filter. If you want to use a K&N filter, it's the KN112, right? I got it on Amazon for really cheap. And Amazon's a piece of shit. If you watch my other videos, you'd know that. They actually told me that this filter was not for this bike. I kept telling them that, warning, you're buying a filter that's not made for your bike. This piece doesn't fit your motorcycle. They're wrong. So I went on Kawasaki's website and K&N's website and found out that this filter is actually made for this bike. So much for Amazon knowing what the fuck they're talking about. And that kind of just goes like that, rubber side towards the engine. Okay, so all I'm doing is I'm putting these bolts back. I'm using an extension so that I can get in there without touching this pipe. Ready now to to put the oil back into here. Yes, I did have this cracked before, for all you know-it-alls. I had it cracked so that it would drain easier, but I close it back up because I don't want fucking grass and shit getting in here. It takes one quart, which is great, because you know all you have to do is fill it up with this and then check it and it should be good. That's pretty stuffy because I'm doing it for one. Okay, so the engine oil is all done. It's filled up. The other thing that you're gonna wanna do is to just double check the oil. You wanna screw it all the way down per manual, and you wanna just check to make sure everything is kosher, which it should be. And that is good. This nifty little tip that I saw from Jake the Garden Snake is if you can't really see the oil, you just lay it on a paper towel and you could see how much oil is there in comparison. Great tip, never knew that. I can't say that I thought of it. Fire it up and make sure that nothing blows up. Hey guys, well I hope this was informative and short and to the point and wasn't a drunken fucking ramble. It's very easy. If you've never done before, just watch this video step by step. You'll understand it. You need an 8mm socket, you need a 17mm socket, a socket extension, and an Allen head to take off the bottom fairing. And that's about it. That's all you need, some paper towel and some patience. A funnel, and obviously the oil, and the oil filter. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button. If you're a new viewer, don't forget to subscribe. I make videos every single week. Peace out.